catalysis. We already know that catalyst is to alter the rate of a chemical reaction. So in this reaction, potassium perchloride decomposes to give potassium chloride and oxygen. When we add a manganese dioxide as the catalyst to this reaction, its temperature is been lowered, and at higher rate or accelerated rate, the rate of reaction to be occur in a faster rate, where the mass and composition means of the reactant is unchanged. So this is catalyst is reaction, and catalysis is classified in mainly into two types: homogeneous and heterogeneous catalyst. Homogeneous means the same reactants, molecules, products, catalyst, and all are in the same phase. We said to be the reaction as homogeneous. For example, the oxidation of sulfur dioxide into sulfur trioxide in the presence of dioxygen as catalyst. Next is acetic acid undergo reaction to give methanol, where all in this reactions the reactants, the product molecules, reactant molecules all are in the same phase. Another example for homogeneous catalyst is hydrolysis of sugar, which is converted to sucrose and fructose molecule, is also an example for homogeneous catalysis. Next reaction is heterogeneous catalysis, where the reactant product molecule and the catalyst molecules are all in different phase. This is the reaction happen for heterogeneous catalyst. For example, oxidation of sulfur dioxide to sulfur trioxide in the presence of platinum, where sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide are in gaseous phase and platinum is a solid phase. Another example is Haber process. We already heard about Haber process, which is ammonia preparation process, where the reactants are nitrogen and hydrogen, which is a gaseous molecule, and it forms ammonia. Ammonia is also gaseous. And this reaction happen in the presence of the catalyst spongy ion, which is a solid phase. Another example is Ostwald process, where the reaction between ammonia and oxygen to give nitric oxide, which is used as the catalyst as platinum, where platinum is in solid phase. Another example is hydrogenation of vegetable oil to give vegetable ghee, where vegetable oil is liquid and hydrogen is a gaseous, and it react in the presence of nickel as the catalyst to give vegetable ghee. The mechanism behind heterogeneous catalyst is adsorption theory. It explained as the reactant in the gaseous state or in the solution are absorbed on the surface of the solid catalyst, which increase the concentration of the reactant on the surface and increase the rate of the reaction. Since adsorption is an exothermic process, the heat of adsorption is utilized in enhancing the rate of the reaction. And this mechanism involves 5 steps. First one is diffusion of reactant to the surface of the catalyst. Second one is adsorbing the reactant molecule on the surface of the catalyst. And third one is occurrence of chemical reaction on the catalyst surface through formation of intermediate. Fourth step is desorption of reactant product from the catalyst and thereby making the surface available again for main reaction to occur. And fifth one is diffusion of reactant product away from the catalyst surface. So whole idea is, first one is the reactant molecule get absorbed on the surface of catalyst, and at the surface of the catalyst the reactant is chemisorption is occur, where the reactant concentration increases on the surface, and in third says it forms an intermediate with the catalyst, and in fourth step it is converted to product molecule by leaving reactant and catalyst. So these are the mechanism behind heterogeneous catalysis. Mainly the solid catalyst is depend upon various factors. First factor is activity. Activity of the catalyst is depend upon the strength of the chemisorption to a large extent, which means it depend upon the chemisorption process. The reactant must get adsorbed reasonably strongly onto the catalyst to become active. However, they must not get adsorbed so strongly that they are immobilized and other reactants are left with no space on the catalyst surface for adsorption. It has been found that for hydrogenation reaction, the catalytic activity increases from group 5 to group 11 metals, with maximum activity being shown by group 7 to 9 elements of the periodic table. So, activity means it depends upon the strength of the chemisorption of reactant species. Next property is selectivity. Selectivity means the ability to direct a reaction to yield a particular product. When under the same reaction condition, many products are possible. Selectivity of different catalyst of same reactant is different. For example, starting with hydrogen and carbon monoxide, we use different kind of catalyst. For example, methanol, methanol, etc. Next one is enzyme catalysis. Enzyme is one of the biological catalyst. There are number of cavity present on the surface of colloidal particles of enzyme. And these cavities of characteristic shapes and process active groups such as NH2, COOH, SHOH, etc. These are actually the active centers on the surface of enzyme particle. The molecule of the reactant which have a complementary shape, which means that the reactant molecule have a particular shape that fit the cavity, which means just like a lock and key model. So the mechanism of the enzyme catalysis is lock and key model. I just simply illustrate what is lock and key model, and this is the lock and key model, where enzyme is act as a key and substrate act as a lock. So first enzyme and the substrate forms an intermediate, that is enzyme substrate complex, and in second side it leaves the substrate as product and enzyme is remains that way. That means the catalyst have no effect where the reactant molecule is completely converted to product molecule. So this is the mechanism behind the enzyme catalyst reaction, that is lock and key model, where the lock is considered as the substrate and the key is considered as the enzyme, which means the catalyst. So the first reaction or the first step is binding of enzyme with the substrate, that means catalyst bind on the surface of the reactant to form an activated complex. And in second step, that there is a decomposition reaction where the catalyst is remain free and the product are formed. So this is the reaction happen here. So this is the mechanism behind enzyme catalyst reaction.